You are watching VoiceTech Engineering YouTube channel by Muhammad Abdul Mehboob, and today I am explaining the isometric problem. In that you are having this question means isometric projection of a cone. I am going to explain you in detail, so watch my videos till the end. And this problem is applicable to diploma, ITI and engineering students, and this problem is of 10 to 15 marks for different branches. So watch my videos till the end and also practice by yourself, then only you will come to understand how to draw this problem after watching my video. And please guys, please share my videos, like and please subscribe my channel, and also press my YouTube channel bell icon to get you the more notification of videos. So starting my question. Draw the isometric projection of a cone of 50 mm base circle diameter and 75 mm axis height. So first of all, what is cone? Cone will be like this. Okay, cone will be like this. Its orthographic view will be means top view and front view will be. If you see this cone from the top, it looks like a circle. Means it looks like a circle. So the circle diameter is 50 mm. As given in the question. Okay, if you see this cone from the front view, it looks like a triangle like this. Okay, and this will be a pyramid. Okay, so this is the front view of the cone. The height of this pyramid is how much? Axis height is how much? 75 mm. So its height is 75 mm. But in the isometric projection, we have to first draw the isometric scale. As I have shown in my previous videos that how to draw this isometric scale, and this is the true length and this is the isometric scale. So with the isometric length only we have to draw this orthographic view and isometric view. So how to draw? See, I am going to explain you and draft you. So please watch my videos till the end. So first we have to draw this orthographic view. So to draw the orthographic view, first you have to take an XY line or a normal line to draw this circle. But in the question, to draw this circle it is given 50 mm. But we have to take the isometric scale 50 mm, this much length to draw the circle. So how to take means this is the circle diameter, this much circle it is diameter. To draw this much circle, 50 half will be 25. So we have to adjust till 25, then you have to draw like this. Means isometric length, with isometric length dimension we have drawn the circle. Then after we have to take the projection line from the center point like this, and from these two ends also like this till that normal line or XY line. The remaining line we are getting, we have to darken because this is the base of the pyramid here. So we have to draw a pyramid. So to draw the pyramid you need an axis height. In axis height is given 75 mm in the question. So for the 75 mm you have to take the isometric scale 75 mm like this, and adjust your divider from here. Your 75 mm length is drawn for the axis. Now you have to draw the axis line like this. Then after slant adjust, you have to draw for the pyramid. A pyramid has been created. Then after we have to show the dimension of this axis height by taking extension line, and this one is the dimensioning line, and show the dimension as 75 mm. And also we have to show the diameter by taking extension lines of this circle, dimensioning line like this, and diameter is 50. Your orthographic view is created. Then after, to draw the isometric scale, you have to draw a normal line or an imaginary line like this. and take a point here and keep your protractor like this, adjust your protractor correctly, and from here you have to take 30 degree angle, and from here you have to take 30 degree angle. With that dots you have to draw a line like this. Convenient, how much you want to take you can take, and from here also you have to take and show the angle you have taken, how much, 30 degree, and here also you have taken 30 degree. Okay, then after this circle has to draw here in a rhombus. So first of all we have to draw a rhombus, then after we have to copy this circle in that rhombus. So how to copy? I am giving you a simple process how to draw. You have to take this circle in a square like this. Then label it as 1, 2, 3, 4. Then this rhombus, according to the dimension of this circle, I am drawing here by copying this dimension from 1 to 2. Adjust it on your divider and copy this, and this one will be 1 and 2, and 1 to 4, measure your divider and draw here on that 30 degree line, and this will be 4. The remaining third point of the rhombus, to remove that, adjust immediately after to that angle, and from 2 draw a line this much, and adjust your divide a minute after to that 30 degree angle, and from 4 draw a line where these two lines are meeting, that point will be 3. Then after rhombus has been created, now to copy this circle we have to measure the distance of the circle where this from 1 to 2 where the circle is meeting. So exactly half of the circle dimension you will have. So with that dimension only you have to copy and do take an arc like this, and 2 to 3 the same dimension you will have half of this. You have to take the arcs on each lines of the rhombus. Then after to draw the circle you have to do the process where from 3 you have to 2 you have to draw the line from this to this arc and to this arc. Like this, and here also with the scale I will draw, because minute after is somewhat not adjusting to have a clear hand on this sheet. So from 1 we have to take the lines and also you have to draw a line from 2 to 4 and 1 to 3 like this. Then after you have to draw a circle, the base of the this cone. So to draw the base of the cone, this cone is, if you see a 3D view, this cone, this half of the circle is visible from the front because we are the observer. So half of the circle is visible from here, so we have to darken. The remaining half circle is backside. It is invisible. For the invisibility, you have to do it dot dot line. So first of all, I will draw this half circle which is visible by adjusting your divider on 3 and fill it with that line. And from that line, you have to draw an arc till this, till half this much portion. Then after keeping your protractor divider here and adjusting your divider and drawing the remaining arc, and from here also this half portion is visible, the remaining half portion is not visible, so you have to adjust your divider with that length and to put a dot dot line like this from there, and from here also like this, and the remaining portion from 1 you have to keep and adjust your divider and put a dotted line like this. Sorry, this bottom of the cone you have created. Now the axis height is 75 mm, but according to the isometric length we have taken, so how much is the length? We have to measure it. That 6 mm I am getting. So from here we have to take the axis height 6 mm. You have to draw 60 mm. Sorry. Draw the axis line like this. Then after, you have to draw the slant edges of the cone, which is visible from the front. You have to dark it. Then from here also, your cone has been created of the isometric position. So also you have to show the dimension of this. From axis to axis only you have to take a extension line like this and like this, and dimensioning line, arrow marks, and this one is 75 mm. Okay, and this is the complete solution of the isometric position of a cone. So please guys, if you like my videos, please share, watch and like my videos, and please also subscribe my channel, and also press in my YouTube channel bell icon to get with the more notifications. So please guys, watch my videos and practice by yourself. Okay, thank you.